So we're here at Donington Park to celebrate 65 years of Norton. In front of me is one of the original long stroke Manx Nortons, and what I've also got is Josh Brooks's current TT Norton, which the crew are just bringing from around the corner. So what's it like comparing the last 65 years of Norton from first to current? So I've been lucky enough to test Josh Brooks's current TT Norton. The team brought the bike from around the corner, but because Stuart's house, who runs Norton, is just over there, I only got a handful of laps, but it did give me a flavour of what the bike is like. It was still on TT gearing, it was still on TT setups, it was just first and second on most of the corners here at Donington. Down Craner and in the flowing bits, you can feel that how the bike flows. Really nice stability and a nice flow to it. It's not really fast steering, which is what you'd expect. TT bikes generally are, they're quite long and raked out, so they are quite nice flowing and fluid. Power is obviously immense. Give it a big handful, first four gears and it wants to wheelie. Auto blipper, quick shifter, the clutch is deactivated as soon as you leave pit lane. But it also gives you a massive respect to what Josh did on that bike. For me, I was shattered in four laps and Josh is riding around there for six laps. When you compare the TT Norton to a road bike, I think it's more like a BMW S1000R, it's more road bike. You know, like Panigales, even the new Fireblade, and they're all kind of small, do you know what I mean? Where that, TT bikes generally, everything's kind of spaced out, the bars are quite wide, pegs are quite wide. So from an ergonomics point of view, it's more like a road bike, which would be more like an S1000R. Power-wise, you've got that torque, and it's more like the V4, but the gear in here is probably longer than a road bike. So a road bike, you'd use more changes. So it'd actually feel faster, a road bike, where that only really feels fast when you can let it rip, which is, you know, coming out of the final corner onto the back straight and over the start finish. So compare it to a road bike, it's quite difficult. But you don't need to rev the nuts off it like an S1000 or a ZX10. It's got drive. You can rack and it drives, and it's not peaky or it doesn't fall into any peaks or trough. So my road, when I last rode a big bike at the TT, it was 180 brake, and this is 220, 230 brake. So next up will be the original. Let's see what the long stroke's like. So, an original Manx Norton, what an amazing opportunity to ride it here at Donington Park. Thanks to Ian Bain, who's lent us this bike, and this bike will be at Goodwood shortly. First of all, it's kind of unique that this bike went round the TT in those early 50s with Jeff Duke and people like that. And there's nothing really from about 4,500 RPM it starts making power, 5 it pulls clean, at 6.5 it's kind of gone. And that's because of the open megaphone exhaust and because of the gearing, and that's how Norton designed the bike. Yet then when we get on the modern TT bike, 65 years later, it's long geared and it only works at the top end. So 65 years, we've got the same problem at the TT in that we are stretching bikes, making them stable, giving them long gearing and putting all the power at the top. So right foot shift, left foot on the back brake, 4-speed, actually steers really, really well. The shocks have not been changed in over 60 years, so Ian tells me. And it handles surprisingly well. Vibrations are pretty immense if you're used to modern stuff. It is like fingers tingle, feet tingle. The shoe brakes are okay for this type of bike. But what I was quite surprised was how fluid and how well it did actually handle. You know, you could, if we was allowed to race this bike, you could put some respectable lap times in. And just kind of like, to get a bit misty-eyed for about it, this is what they were riding. You know, these were the boys that were going around the TT 60, 65 years ago, when the track was very different to how it is now, even though people tell you it's the same track. It was a lot tighter, and some of the corners were even a tarmac. To shift gear, it's not too bad, because I use the old, so if your head goes down, as in if you're accelerating, you push down on the gear, you pop your head up, come up on the gear. So you just got to remember to do that with the right foot. That's not too bad. Left foot back braking, just didn't bother. My left foot is there for changing gear, and so I just left the left foot on the peg. I didn't bother trying with the back brake. The kind of odd bit is any modern bike will pull from 1200 or 1000 RPM. This below 4000 almost stalls. It's like that splutters really bad, but that's due to the open megaphone exhaust and the way it's fueled for long geared tracks like Goodwood and the TT. So we could put a different exhaust on it, but this is how they would have ridden it in the day. You know, this is how Jeff Duke would have ridden it. So the kind of difficult bit was to get the right gear for the corner, because if you're in the wrong gear and you try and come out the S's, it'll be bap, 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 bap. And then you can't mechanically think, right, I've got to come back a gear, because you've got such a short power band. It must have been incredibly difficult to ride, and they must have been really methodical how they chose their gears. But as Ian, the owner, was telling me, there was a huge amount of gears that you could use, and you could have, you know, change the gearing so it was long and short. It's only a 4-speed box. So a lot of the skill I can see now was the bike setup, not just from Norton, but the rider working out what gear he needed to be when he went up Hillwood's Rise, you know, to get the best drive or to come out of the Craig. Would that be second or would that be third? And that's where they were making or losing time, I imagine. Any modern bike really today in 2018, the brakes are always the same. So you brake, and because it's hydraulic, it'll be the same. With shoe brakes, they overheat. So the first two pulls of the lever, it's not too bad, and it'll just get worse and worse and worse. And it changes throughout the lap, because if you go into Redgate quite hard, then you're not really hard on the brakes or the S's. So it feels okay into the S's because it's cooled down a bit, but then it goes a bit weak at Redgate. So it's never the same brake. And then the longer you ride it, the more it changes. And what you pull on the lever is what goes into the shoe brake. Where with hydraulic or modern brakes, like especially on BMW, you just, it's one finger on the lever. Here, it's all four fingers and pulling it for all your might. The harder you pull, the more you stop.